minor, part one. Screen grab a bit, at that point I knew we would be late. It's all I see. In a mind's eye welling up, left running, my frustrations are behind the car, waving frantically. Come back to the past! Port tiles swollen, overflow of miserable failure, extinguishing nothing but dreams. The hope burning a crisp block of a pizza in the oven at the pit of my stomach. Fit for any sarcastic mantelpiece at a student's fancy dress club. And then she. She beats my disappointment and says it needs seasoning and I shouldn't have burnt it. I clench fists, willing wolverine claws to burst through so I can savagely tear her to tatters and play with her guts like spaghetti. Stop her scoffing like a blind pig still alive under the cloche. I press my forks into my temples, anything to erase this abominable travesty. Wipe clean the slab where the corpse of any one of the moments had releases its final gases. You can do one, you're spoiling me. You're spoiling everything. You can do one. Winston loved a big brother in the end, but that won't happen here. Art is dead. A banshee of Tinnitus sings. Grow in this mind, Dan. You live in the cold now. Learn to love your new friends and stalagmites dance in the drips together. No rescue, no remorse. No mercy, all shattered to a cold block, lead soil, still conscious. Along with Louise the hamster, who would you would be capable of loving enough to replace all of me. Will you love me, Mr. Worm? Ticking pizza, the black disc of the myelometer counts hot eyes. We won't be home in time, will we? We won't be home in time. Oh my God. Nothing matters after this. Can't you go any faster? You should have set the timer on the VCR. You should have set the timer, Dan. My perfect collection smeared, desiccated by treachery, disrespect, the library destroyed, the school, the hospital, bombshell. How many notable buildings passed before we are home and I can salvage what's left? Distractions can't stop me, snapping all my China raw pencils. I don't care how Uncle Ray's aluminium or how to pronounce it. I'm never going to school again. I arrive a ghost rider, a bus. A handbrake cracks, punctuate, a crotch full of pieces after a broken down roller coaster. 3 minutes. 3 minutes of giant blue skyline. It had to be, didn't it? The most exciting episode of the real Ghostbusters ever. I knew they'd be missing. The annals of time, the jigsaw, of which you hoovered up the last piece. 3 wishes. I wish you were dead. 1. I wish you, 2. Also wish you were dead. 3. The fact you gave birth to me, nothing but a cheap trinket and a bucket of shit. I wish it was you, Palmer, crushing the dreams of the only past. In slow motion, you hobgoblin, you Hitler. My 18 grand is going down the stairs. I'm not asking permission to eat this biscuit. I'm really childlike, you cunt. I don't like my bike. I'm not wearing that helmet. I'm going to get tattooed and start smoking. I'm going to watch Strange Hill. I'm making guns out of Lego. And I'm not going to wipe my ass properly. Blue Slimer, part 2, healing. When she tells you she grew up in a sweet shop, you're with she wrote poetry too. Two of the farmer's views are sent to smash the bridge of tranquility, scaring the fairies, teaching in new curses, in the asbestos hangar, the rusty tractor on which we play, a half-heard dream, my first faux pas. The policeman confirmed it. Blue snippers couldn't afford the rent. The goats and pigs could. I remember looking in the eyes and playing in the radio. I remember Russell's scabby hands putting a chew-chew gummy giving me in my pocket as it was forbidden. shoelaces, corkscrews, swollen knuckles, history, being in chemistry in doubles, it's chestnut season, boiled vinegar, box stalls in airing cupboards, poker faced under the table tactics. At the centre of the study class, no man's could match Pee-wee, Miles' champion conquer, the mouse that was the elephant in the room, Goliath modestly tinkled in the cubicle, weeing around the rim, so Splash goes unjudged, David lavish with urinals to go round, pays no mind, gets on with his day like heroes do. Mighty, mighty Pee-wee, forever an empire-defeating proton torpedo, even in its own autumn, brains exposed, Rocky, Rambo, all the Stallones, it took down one after the next, Demolition Man, consistent in contest, constant in victory, conquering conquer, Valhalla, Pee-wee. Blue Slimer, Part 3, Side B. Brown Bear Radio plays black music on the Disney Doyle my dad drew. After bath time on Sunday to bed, I write in my Thomas Tank diary, wishing for Mighty White with a short blue biro. Dream of possessed typewriters as laughing echoes from downstairs. Rude Ralph, blind, his only eye lost under an oily pile of spanners. In the workshop, insectoid man's patina inspires the scientist within me, but I still cry when given a chemistry set for my birthday. I was a horrid, ungrateful child, but I was. And I was tolerated, I was snotty and divisive, but my evil was cherished. I remember asking my mum what religion we were. Church of England, she said. Do you believe in God, I later asked. Well, I don't know really, I believe in something. I believe I was her punishment, her omen, her Damien. I was a horrid, ungrateful child, and she loved me like a blue slimer. Blue Slimer, Part 4, Lost Keys. Blowing my mind, she lays on a pile of books. You take the money, you take the like money on the floor. Give her 3 minutes to delete your comment. I need to remember what it's like waiting myself to end. Instead of ending it myself. It might not be the way it's supposed to end. It might not be the way it's supposed to end.
Don't look at either of them, or you'll call me the same split. The financial times blushes and their jingling SMS features, and they both run stories from people past eight breaches. From Atfield lies to abortion home after gay genes finding. That was printed in 1993. It should despise, deplore and more copies, protest and chastise. Would wipe your ass with what the pages of Keith's Orban Rothschild devise. I'd rather use my penis as a folded skewer holder. I'd rather set fire to that pews and watch them blacken and smolder. Peel back my foreskin and try and serve it a boulder. But walk down the streets through a mulch press holder. I'd rather get a paper cut on my iris. I'd rather drink a gallon of vinegar and wince when I take a piss. I'd rather pierce my lungs to resemble machines. Perhaps with the Detail Project insanity, fuck off. You're dismissed. Don't look at the sun. The Daily Mail's also shit. Don't look at the sun. The Daily Mail's also shit. I'm repeating this to you now. And now it's your bit. Don't look at the sun.
The Daily Mail's also shit.
Hang on. Next one's about companies who don't pay their tax. Acer's floppy, Argus foggy, Amazon spins out more lies than deceased disc jockeys. Barclays to fitness, all in repute, so too the tax avoiding BT Group. Dell's a copy, DeLonghi's dodgy, EA, Eon, eBay, Errol Nogging. Fujitsu Fidgets and Cheese Assistant Google should receive all of our data. Pay your taxes, you guys. Hewlett Packard prints off false prints. IKEA should get booted and receive shin splints. Kingfisher, they own B&Q, so hammer it home next time you're through. Pay your taxes, you guys. Lenovo don't monitor their fiscal duty. Michael Pavlov who owned Weetabix are turning all soggy. The goblins have been clowning around for years. Mattel create toys yet bring children to tears. Netflix unfortunately has no chill. Nike forgoes their fucking tax bill. Pay your taxes, you cunts. Samsung's accountants are currently on hold. Starbucks coffee can be cold. Spotify premium piss takers. Even Steinway pianos will end up being bailiff greeters. Toshiba toy, Unilever, but they do shampoo and margarine. And Ben and Jerry's spoiling. Vodafone avoidance is fucking flamboyant. Walmart, who own Asda, give it a good punt. Walk into a Walt Disney store and confront. Tell them, blood. Pay your taxes, you cunts. Has anybody here been to a poetry slam? Nice! I'll recount the story to two. Two, alright. So the premise of a poetry slam is basically you get graded on how well you are. Like, if you can remember your lines, you don't fuck up. It's basically a poetic X Factor. Fuck shit. So, there's one on Saturday, and this is my poem about poetry slams. And now it's to you, those who read the pages, the white sheet, broadsheet, biased as hell advert sheet, those who know their similes, metaphors, stanzas, poetic verse family, hopefully, the sitting gravely, in the dark, reviewing my work without knowing the allegory. Shh, you. The audience, hyphenated, separating out the words. I curse this perverse dirge on poetic curve. It curves. Slap, bam, spotlight on. Entertain us, man. Your expectant eyes are caressing my lips. There's a coliseum of prose and enchantment quips. I've got his lines racked up, like Tony Montgrammer. Got his poetic fallacies and stanzas. I won't tweet and find him bleats for you to see his deep peaks and spoken word feats, you see. I'll amuse Bill Shokuth troops to you. Sat there hissing, kicking, cubing, stomping, dropping, popping, poetic nonsense, chorus, the comments over contacts. You want a cockhead Canadian poet in an MC? And that's diluting the writing. It's funny, you say, and unfortunately you're fucking not. Using comedy to honestly shit over poetry. The reason you'll have us all believing is that it enhances the wind, but honestly it's poetic treason. Couldn't get better at writing, so you thought you'd bring a few props. And from these blocks, you thought we like it, whether we like it or not. Timmy Mallet on Pallet in year-to-year insults with 3 minute bells went for it. Welcome to my world. This is Poetry X-Factor, for fuck's sake. I'm not here to shove drunken words in your face. Poetry, like music, is personal taste, not mass appealing to gain award-winning face. Fruit and Serpent, the Poetry Society, ask for members before you can entertain quizzically. I will wait and debate anywhere, fear for me. And you sit there tutting, letting opulent lips make a noise only God should be able to hear. And remarks you deem tutting, how this is with viral plaque or eats. No, I'm smothered. How can I relate to as your season feels a golden husk, when all I see is colour extending the gap like white wing dust? No wonder we reside in grey days. Where's the punk from? Where's the Dylan song? Where's the uprising on Michael Fisher's Orient fucking Island? This isn't anything new, a poetry volume. I've been doing this a while, but you're only just catching me rhyming. And it makes me sicker than the decrepit wisdom that I have to prove my worth now. Where were you, fucking silence and quiet? Don't worry, I see you. You've now fallen off the fence, so tense. Pass, I'm done at last. I'm not doing it. And that's what we need to grasp. Brain is dated, no one needs to prove that they love my work more. Waterstones, bills, and food. I'll keep writing on and you do yours. I pass what you taught and stay wide by my book. The greatest season I see in front of me, my father's buffer, word of original substance. Looks to encapsulate the ground for all of this poetic bubble. My well-thought outline is dissipating, wax being rubber. I don't need your clicks, or belongs to bores. I don't need writing about to ensure snakes and ladders distort. This small town in Alice, built to the grim golden chalice, cemented my place with well thought out palace. And that's it for me. I've ticked all the boxes, and now go out into the town in flocks and foxes and grosses. Strangle hold the next strangely deep till it in your eyes are open for an unshoolish poetic leap. Thank you.
Back in the day, and it's about growing up. I'd have my fingertips in a bag of mini-mix. Back in the day, mate, all sorts of licorice. Fruit salad, blackjack, wine, while living, it was what we did. Before it turned into this adult content, 18 certificate. Flying saucers, pop rocks on the drumsticks. Bear dropping jelly top, lost in his double bin. Milk two gas, mark, heat's on chewing, it was all pain. Like living on a bonbon with sherbet stands. Cream soda cans, too big for my little hands. Swinging back a six pack, building a puppy whack. Now I'm grown up, I want to go back. Switch up the bricks to new guard for cash. Switch up my taste for cocaine and cash. Before you cut the coins of sugar in the bag. The sugar free darkness I didn't understand. Like life's so sweet, I need everything I can. Tell me how we are, that I'm a youth of man. 16 bars of refresher for the gang. Before thoughts of failure and bullshit exams. Before chasing girls became the main plan. Before the smog stains and those games began. With a spoon in a jam, living large on a few pounds. 'Cause back in the day, I'd be unwrapping white rabbits with their ice feet. Bullying off the cousins like giving my favour. Ruining an appetite, maybe have it later. No room for the rhubarb and shallow dry potatoes. N64 don't switch to PlayStation. Sitting on the floor just thinking out animation. Waiting in turn, learning it's been a patient. Think about the fun, but switch the fuck. What was there to worry about is the main question. Glued to the goggle box, we post for breakfast. Cartoons in caramel, oh so stressless. Never really gave a cool fuck for what's next. I didn't realise that that time is precious. Living in the moment with a dairy milk selection. Letting off the cat gun, bubblegum western. Pure fun, sugar rushing round town in the sun. Have a can of pop gun, we'll crack another one. It's back in the day, I used to drink cream soda. Long before the taste of rum and coke took over. Long before I ever felt a weight up on my shoulders. Long before I ever felt the threat of growing older. And life was sweet.
Thank you very much. So that was then, and this is now. It's called Minimum Wage Machine.
Cogs in the mechanism are inanimate. They're lifeless objects, no secrets to their fix. That's how they keep their regimented step in movement. And the same mundane 8 hours as you clueless. Like I can't really think of what my next move is. With a broken record skipping in my head, kicking it. Is that how long have you been here now? Going on a year, David, every day arriving in an equilibrium jigging. And you don't have excuses, just grinning on it, ain't it? The sorry sir, fuck you, pay me. Dance the leading you until we're 80. Nest eggs rave the way, funding getting wavy. That's my generation, in the rented accommodation. Hand-to-mouth living is the only situation. We're all in the same boat, so walking on occasion. Tax, free cash, every time he's got the option. Keep on keeping on, work, box, automaton. 9 to 5, minimum wage, machine be strong. Whether it's the long day, or lighting up the moon shit. Stay high, get by, facilitate your music. Till popping on repeat, spending hours on your feet, autopilot through the week, keep making ends meet, pinching pennies for my week as the time slows at speed. That's a snail's pace, running out the clock with a pale face, coming down all day, no stop for fuel breaks. Last night's dead, I'm still present in my chest pain, wobbling on my feet again, sweating out, playing the game. No putting in sick if you don't work, you're not paid. Switch to the robotic mechanical mindset. Binary rhyme scheme spinning through my eyes state. The vibrance of Saturday night to the mundane raise a transition that never changes. So keep on keeping on, work box automaton. 9 to 5 minimum wage machine be strong. Whether it's the long day or lighting up the moon ship, stay high, get by, facilitate your music.
Okay, so the next one I've got for you is about realisation. I had a personal realisation that I am not the centre of this universe. I'm sure a lot of the people in this room had that too. It's called Copernicus Complex.
Reality connects through Copernicus Complex. Feeling the effect puts the ego into context. In its kinetic energy, you're not at this axis. It's moving on before you, and it keeps on moving after. Reality connects, complex of Copernicus. Moment that intrigued, you're not the center of this universe. Check from reality, like this is how the world works. Sooner that you wake up, the less it's going to hurt. Despite self-entitlement, the need to have it first. Ultimately self-obsessed, people wait their turn. Narcissism manifests itself in a lesson learned. Open eye, understanding something that you learn. Turbulent learning curve, remote objectives. A shock to the system could broaden your perspective. Actions, reaction, butterfly affected. When a bigger picture developed and you're not at the center. Reassess the ego, reflect it in the mirror. And realize that we grow and it's a proper branch. Stylus of life finds its proof in the fact that the stars, sun and moon do not revolve around you. Reality connects through Copernicus complex. Feeling the effect puts an ego into context. And it's kinetic energy, you're not on this axis. It's moving on before you, and it keeps on moving after like snap, root snatch from minus. Worried silhouettes soon outline the silence. Recognize lies, this complex design is past. Intertwined, in synergy, a spiral. Woven with one another, pattern, another fractal. Strengthen the strength. destruction. Tally, hope it's added into the battle that a man alone could never win. Bonds build nourishing a tree of life stings. See a second chance and the olive branch extends. The catch when I'm falling and cushion my descent. And thinking of myself more for thoughts of them. And support threads playing to the fabric of existence. How many bright sparks in this solar system? Conditioned into thinking every pivotal position. Delusions of rancor, a symptom of condition. Pretty soon the truth spins round and it hits them.
Thank you very much. Okay, the next one I've got is about coping mechanisms. Okay. It's Peter Pan's fleeting visit to Diaziland. My gang's the lost thoughts, best to bring up dead and bad. Where yet things are panning out, we'll probably forget a man. Deflect the anxiety, chilling in the middle ground, kicking back, popping bits of bliss out of blister pack. £10 back, that's up like a 20-minute rant. Running like a leap here, like, what were we just talking about? Where were we just going, man? Shit, I should have gone it down. Blueberry eating, it doesn't really matter now. I'm lucid dreaming, dripping in a glass. Knocking like a knocky dog, land of not bound. Snoring like a rocker log for 14 hours. Stir for the sounds, kettle clicking in the kitchen. Sedate next round, a day half twisted. Bottle in the workplace, dropping all the dishes. And making my apologies for forgetting to listen. I drift away, losing days. Not asleep, but not quite awake. 2 10-minute blueberry white here again. It's a pop-pop till you drop-drop situation. You value your hashish and hip-hop blend. This value your hashish and hip-hop blend. I'm drifting away, losing days. Not asleep, but not quite awake. Illicit prescriptions, divine intervention, a pharmaceutical brain of all from my perception. Chemicals we're messing with, maybe recreational, but switch from the habitual to just business as usual. I couldn't give a fuck about what you think is acceptable, especially when floating around like an extraterrestrial. Lose a couple days snoozing, siesta festivalist, compass mentis becoming pure irrelevance. Concept of consequence melting to nothingness in the hashish of hot lies like expel stress. Food to your soul, meat so delicious. Using a facade in the rhythm of your breath. Faulting your beats, I'm running with a consent. But how will she remain as a murdering consent? As I'm going to give a fuck about. Give me two more of them. Snoozing on the floor of my room, lying as a bed. Okay, the next one I've got is called Morning Light. I wrote that after a music festival.
Vibrant features came to life within that morning light. Breaking dawn arrived, smiling eyes reflected the light. An oasis in the chaos, an example of how paths collide when tied into the movements of passing ships within the night. Boundaries collapse, those paths intertwine, connected with the chemistry of ecstasy and mind. Bodies fluid with the music, the vibes in the twilight. Form frozen, strobe lit memories in closed eyes. Visions of the previous, reminiscing morning light. Blissfully inhibitionless, the time flies by. I'm so high, I'll be fine. I'm rewired. Like, tell me what it takes to feel alive. If there isn't this, feeling like I'm tapped into some collective consciousness. Seemingly the synapse firing in unison. But in that morning light, my silhouette eclipses the sun.
Just
to realize every cloud's very silver line. The pattern of the negative and positive combined blends into twine, spinning into fractals. This mosaic of piles of hairline fractures of opposite reaction. Catastrophe happens within it. There's a whole glimmer of light. This a map to the complex symphony of bright piercing jet black, chased away the darkness, illuminating facts. Guidance in the spark, inspired to make tracks, shining through my past to show me where I'm at. It's the struggle of the uphill, bringing up the flat. Reaching in perception when looking at the glass. Half of my empties, the question that I ask, and silent reply as the second hand pass. It's minutes into hours, and I still ain't nothing back. Cause you and only you can realize the fact. Hindsight lights are far, far beyond. The darkness only lasts for so long. Who knows what's brought on breaking dawns, like who knows what may rise from this soil. Nothing's for certain, just be sure the darkness only lasts for so long. There's a ripple effect emanating from the situation, reassessing hindsight, point of view changes. Blessing born from stress, the overleap of page is soaked with the instinct, footsteps of moves made. Reflect to calculate, maybe find another way. Recognize a lesson learned, telling real from fake. I realize I'm not pinned to the path I take. It burns in the ash once another game to play. My fingertips trace bright stripes in that grey. A stray rose rises, breaks through the embers. This new way of life may appear in the cinders, and suddenly the previous is something to remember. Nothing but a whisper on lips of elders, equipped to set sail, guided by errors, flip to their plus side, providing direction. I take to a road on a moment of reflection. Hindsight lights the path far beyond. The darkness only lasts for so long. Who knows what's brought on breaking thorns, like who knows what may rise from this soil. Nothing's for certain, just be sure the darkness only lasts for so long.
But the next one I've got is about human interaction. We meet, we click, and then we never see each other again.
Sands in the wind. Sands in the wind. Have momentary contact and never meet again. This life's like a cyclone caught within its spin. Impression of the impact is left beneath my skin. I fill it in with ink and carry on traveling. Feel my guts sinking when the reminiscence kicking in. Gripped by the shadows of my past, flinch backwards over in a hollow. Just whispering all a piece of hey, who really remembers anyway? Faced with another name, next fresh new face, another set of stages within an intricate maze. Still, it's keepsaking for is an hour, a cage, another cliche. Mistake to moves that's made, the scenery may change, but the plot stays the same. Winds dash and rearrange, pebbles in a hurricane. Overtones and undercurrents pull them out of place like sands in the wind. Sands in the wind. Made their motion through a swollen iris when we met, thinking, hey, didn't I know you for a split second? Second take, the passing hands of time echoed. I reckon, I recognize the eyes. Long flow, another life, same face, different mind. Frozen or paralyzed, in the warm yellow, your rose color retrospect. Tinted at reality, openly interpret that. Anywhere you want to be, living in the past, or an example to follow. Is wishing on the stars, the reason I'm feeling wallow. With yesterday's marks and a beast, more tomorrow. Pass me the mask I beg still to borrow with. Give me half a chance, darling, silver tongue rhetoric. Dropping in a promise I honestly did intend to keep. But sweet whispers dismissed in the flickering wings. Like sands in the wind, sands in the wind. Love moments every contact and never meet again. This life's like a cyclone caught within a spin. Impression of every impact is left beneath my skin.
Right, so it's called Flowers by the Bedside.
Flowers by the Bedside. Eventually crisped up and crumpled to dust. That foregone conclusion for every single one of us. Life's like thickens from bright to dark, mimicking the cycle of the sun sinking to the moon rise. But it's hard to comprehend through naive, childish eyes. Blind to bereavement, grief or wondering why. Where once was a sun sitting in a blue sky, was just light's reflection in pitch black of night. Thinking at the time how could never be sufficed, or forever I'll remember closed lifeless eyes. A vessel in a casket, so sprung to fly, ascending to the heavens, stepping to the other side. Free from this illness, the bitter tainting wines, the war towards the battlefield, no shadow in his mind. Spirit from a cage, left a broken body behind. With life's last breath, the thorn left his side. Now wilted petals fall from where the stones are left behind. Dried out like a sickle through the course of their time. With unanswered questions to revisit in their minds.
they're anchored by their language, as the flowers fly outside.
Lost but not forgotten. Remember, never let go. These platitudes hanging in the air like a thick smoke, choking on hollow words, void of their meaning, seeding one another, trying to comprehend my feelings. But over a decade's passed, the time's stealing, and 10 years move so fast, no rereading. Teenage years all run with no reason, although my visits are a little less frequent. It's intermittent thinking at the bedside, daydreaming, wishing I could have grasped the time frame simply. Maybe I could have asked some direct questions. Got direct answers, no second-hand impression. No rose-tinted lenses or element of venom. Met you as a grown man and form my own opinions. Be subject to the knowledge others pass on to their children. Find out how you found England under central visions. Discover what ambition had you drifted over ocean to land in this place where I've rooted and grown. Discover what ambition had you drifted over ocean to land in this place that your seed calls its home.